But I've got to wait here in my family tree for my real family.
Cool thing about Tiggers is Tiggers are marvelous chaps. They're loaded with thimble with vigor. They love to leap in your laps.
Welcome back to Disney Marvels for week of November 22nd, 2020. This is episode 110. Disney Marvels, the show about Disney, Marvel, Lucasfilm, Pixar, 20th Century Fox, the parks, and much, much more. If it has to do with Disney, it's fair game. I'm your host, Matthew Graykin. Hey, so I put a survey out there talking about the Darkwing Duck reboot that we discussed last week. And of the options, yes, let's get dangerous. You're excited. You're ready for this. You're cautiously optimistic. Or you're not interested whatsoever, so nope. 25% of you said, yes, let's get dangerous. You're excited for this reboot. You're looking forward to it. 75% of you, though, said you're cautiously optimistic. But, thankfully, nobody said that they're not looking forward to this. That nope was an answer. So, most of you, you're cautiously optimistic. I can understand it. But after seeing what they've done with DuckTales, you know what? I can't help but be positive about it and think, you know what? They did that good job with DuckTales. We should have a good feeling for what's coming for Darkwing Duck. Now, I understand the showrunner's going to be a little different, but you know what? I think they got something going here. Fingers crossed. And we'll see what happens. All right. And you know what? We'll be back after these messages from our friends and sponsors.
Hi, Disney Marvels fans. My name's Tash, and my BFF Mercedes and I make a weekly podcast dedicated to all things Disney. From music, movies, and food and parks to fun weekly challenges, we discuss it all over at Chat Disney. You can find us on Instagram at Chat Disney or Twitter at Chat Disney UK. We release weekly episodes every Monday morning, which can be found on Spotify and the Apple Podcast app. Bye for now.
And now, on with the show.
Funny how a photograph can take you back in time to places and embraces that you thought you'd left behind. They're trying to remind you that you're not the only one, that no one is an island when all is said and done.
I was sitting in my car the other day, and driving along, my kids are watching a movie in the background, and it dawned on me, there's another movie that was related to the one that they were watching that I wanted to talk about. They were watching the original Winnie the Pooh, and they were really enjoying it, and it was nostalgic for me, and, you know, just, it's one of those feel-good movies, and then watching my kids watch a movie that I enjoyed as a kid, and just, again, not having to worry about what they're watching, what they're being exposed to, just pure innocence and enjoyment, which is what, you know, the Winnie the Pooh character is innocence. And I thought, well, there's another movie tied into this that I want to talk about because I enjoyed it. And then I realized it's the 20th anniversary of this movie back in February, and I forgot to talk about it. So, the movie I'm talking about is 2000's The Tigger Movie. And it's not the first movie Disney did after Winnie the Pooh. But I want to say it's probably one of the better ones that they have done. Following Pooh's Grand Adventure, and then there was several movies after even this one. Pooh's Grand Adventure, we'll maybe get into that some other day if I feel up to it. And I'm not saying this is the best movie of all times, that it tops the original movie. Definitely not. But there are parts of it that really, really pulls at the heartstrings. The synopsis of the movie is that Tigger is missing other Tiggers. That he's walking around one day and he wants to do things. He wants to do Tigger things. He wants to go bouncing with his friends or with others. And no one either is able to do it at the moment, or no one understands it. And this kind of leaves him with an empty feeling inside of how, well, someone's got to understand what I want to do and why I want to do things. And, you know, obviously Pooh is not a bouncer. The only one that is interested is Roo. And he's talking to Roo, and they go talk to Owl, and Owl's talking about, well, his family, you know, there's a long line of owls, and we've done this, and we've done that, and this owl, and that owl. And this got Tigger to thinking, well, what about my family? So the adventure of this movie is Tigger sets out to try to find his family. Now, does it get goofy at times? Does it get a little silly and far-fetched at times? Yes. I mean, it is... It's not the original movie. The original Winnie the Pooh movie, which is a bunch of collaborations of shorts, of course, but this is a movie unto itself, an original story based on the characters of. Now, it doesn't have Gopher in it, which was not an original character from the book. It was a character that the Disney company came up with. The animation studio decided, we're going to put this character in for a little comic relief. Just need that extra little character in there. And, but this is more, I guess, based on the variation or the storylines from the many adventure of Winnie the Pooh television series, or Adventures of Winnie the Pooh television series that was out in the early 90s, late 80s, early 90s. So you have a slight diversion of the character traits in the animation style, as much as they tried to stay true to it. A lot of this animation wasn't done in the home Burbank studios. It was done over in the Japan studios, but very clean lines, love attention to detail. But you watch the two congruently, or just, you know, one following the other anyway, you'll realize that there is a quite a bit of a diversion, where the original one, the lines aren't as clean, also due to the time that it was made, and just the style of animation. It is different. But something big happened with this movie. And it was originally planned to be a direct-to-video release, until then chairman Michael Eisner heard the score of the movie and immediately decided to bring it to theatrical worldwide release. Who did the score is the kind of the important thing to this movie. It was the first movie since 1971's Bedknobs and Broomsticks to have the songs created by Richard M. Sherman and Robert B. Sherman. So you had the Sherman brothers come back to create the music for this movie. And that really does help sell this movie. Between Lullaby and Your Heart Will Leave You Home and the Super Ooper Duper Looper Bounce, and stuff like that. It's the Sherman Brothers. That's all I have to say. It's the Sherman Brothers. And Your Heart Will Lead You Home, which is the main song from the movie. It plays at the end of the credits. Is performed by Kenny Loggins. It's the first time that the Sherman Brothers collaborated with somebody, with another songwriter. And Kenny Loggins performs the song, and it is, it's what helped me or made me fall in love with this movie. Because it really brings home the story and the message of the movie of family. And beyond some of the goofy aspects of it, beyond some of the craziness and the little goofy moments, that the last, I want to say, 15 minutes of the movie is so sincere and so touching. And I'm going to try not to ruin it for you, but it really, it changes the perception of the movie, and you come walking away feeling, you know, with the feels. I just watched it just moments before recording this, and I still get a little teary-eyed at the end. And then that song plays, and it just kind of sums up the whole thing so nicely in verse that you just can't help but have the feels, because it reminds you of the important things in life, and it reminds you of who should be important in your life. And you know, having that connection with people, or just who is your family, is kind of an underlying question in this story. And at the end, obviously, it reveals who the family is. Who is Tigger's family? And it's kind of one of those moments that I think a lot of people in certain situations have experienced themselves, or have gone through this journey to find this same answer of who's their real family. And again, it's a very adult topic put into an animated movie that the entire family could watch and enjoy, and take out different levels of things that are age appropriate, or bring up conversations or discussions and open up discussions about who is family, what does family mean, you know, is all family related, you know, or is all family, you know, biologically related, you know, being an adopted father. This was even before any of that happened, but I still connected with this movie with that aspect. And it really ties that message in nicely. I mean, Jim Cummings himself said this is one of his all-time favorite, quote unquote, Winnie the Pooh movies he's ever done. I mean, the man's done so much work, you know, beyond Winnie the Pooh. I mean, it's hard to find something animated that has voice work in it that doesn't have Jim Cummings' name somewhere in there. Darkwing Duck, we spoke about the other last episode, and you know, I spoke to Ted Stones about it, and I even brought up adoption in that. So I applaud Disney for bringing in these themes and topics to their stories. This one in particular, like I said, rewatching it, I see it from a different light. Okay, some of it seems a little campy at times. But like I said, that last, not even half hour, the last 15 minutes really, really just drives the movie home and gives you a beautiful, beautiful message that, especially in times like this, I think everyone would find comfort in. or just appreciate. If you cannot relate, you can't appreciate what the message is here and what the story that they're telling with the 100 Acre Wood characters, what that message is. So it's worth checking out. Again, I won't say it's necessarily always one of my favorite ones. I mean, even if you go back, I found out that the working title of this movie is Winnie the Pooh and the Family Tree. And one of the nice notes, it was kind of sad, Paul Winchell, who was the original voice of Tigger, did try to record for this. And they tried to bring him back. But his voice just... He was in retirement. And they just tried to bring him back from it and hoped that they could salvage something, but they wouldn't. So they, again, tapped Jim Cummings to do Pooh and Tigger. John Fiedler, another episode that I'm just butchering people's names, I apologize, was the last remaining original voice actor of the franchise from the original movies, original shorts. He does Piglet. He's even in Emperor's New Groove. The voice is so... You can really pick out his voice. It's so defined that you know exactly who that is. Where would I rate this movie? See, that's the hard part. If you're talking about the first part of the movie, yeah, I'd have to give it a little bit of a lower score, just because, like I said, it is campy at times. But you can go to the back end of the movie and it helps boost that up. You know, a movie that you start getting feelings, you can kind of relate to, or you just appreciate the message being portrayed and how they portray it. Would it be wrong to say this movie should get... If I balance it out, because the one end is so much higher than the other, and if I draw a line down the middle and dot a couple I's, I would say probably a seven and a half. Seven and a half. We'll go there. 7.5 for the Tigger movie. You have the songs by the Sherman Brothers, and again, that message of family, and who is your family, and what does family really mean, and how family will be there for each other even though they may not always understand you, if they may not always appreciate you, they may not always look like you, but family sometimes is something that is like a fingerprint. There's no two families that are the same. And there is a bond within a family that just because, again, you don't look the same or you don't have the same interests doesn't mean that you're not loved. Moving on from that, let me jump ahead to something that just came out recently. Episode 4 of the season 2, so chapter 12 of The Mandalorian just dropped. And so let me talk about a stretch of a conversation, go from one to the other. So that was this week's episode, really cool. As I said last week, though they hinted at we will be seeing Ahsoka soon, I said I don't think it's going to be the next episode, and I made a good prediction, apparently. that doesn't mean that a lot didn't happen in this episode. A lot of cool things are happening, going on. Things that we already knew have been brought to the attention of the characters. They bring back Carl Weathers comes back, and so you have that whole crew, that end of the galaxy, or the storyline that we saw at the beginning, and Mando left them. He's now come to return to them, and he helps them out with some stuff. And again, the reveals of certain things that we know, that the Grand Moff is still alive. Cool. That's still going on there. All right. So we know that. And this is assuming you've watched everything. So if not, sorry, it's spoilers. But yeah, so he learns that that's still happening, and that things, there's still a danger out there. There's still a threat, which creates more of a sense of urgency. And then we start to get back into some more of the Star Wars themes of who can you trust. You know, that things aren't always what they seem or who they seem. Things like that start popping up. And I don't know. I don't know if they're trying to tie in some of the stuff that was going on in the movies into this to bring forth what was happening at in the three movies that, because remember, this happened before episodes 9, 10, 11, 7, 8, 9. Before is episode 7, 8, 9. Before all those, Force Awakens is when The Mandalorian takes place. So stuff that's happened in those movies, are they bringing it into this? It was hard for me to tell because it was a little dark, but it was visually dark. Really well done. And surprise, surprise, the director of this one, Carl Weathers. Who knew? Apollo Creed himself directed this episode, and it was fantastic. So well done, Carl. Great job. Can't wait to see more work. So definitely check it out. I want to know what you thought of episode 4. And have you watched the Tigger movie? Tell me about it. Join the conversation. Join us on Facebook. Facebook.com/DisneyMarvelsPodcast. Or on our Facebook group, which is Facebook.com/group/DisneyMarvelsPodcast. You also got us on the Instagram @DisneyMarvelsPodcast. And on the Twitter, which is just @DisneyMarvels. You can also email the show with any answers or suggestions or questions that you may have that you would like me one day to answer, and I would be more than happy to do that for you on the show. I'd love to connecting with people via email or any other way to DisneyMarvels@gmail.com. You're not into doing emails? You want to hear yourself on the show? By all means, I will be glad to do that. Leave your voice message through the Anchor app or website, or record it on your device, computer, your smartphone, whatever, and email it through DisneyMarvels@gmail.com to us, and I'll gladly put you on the show. And for the Anchor website, if you want to go that way, we could do that too. Links to that are in the show notes. I want to thank you for your time. I know how little time we all have, how crazy life is, and the fact that you've spent some of this time with me means so much. It really... really is special to me, and I really do appreciate it. Like I said, you know, the theme here is family, and you're my Disney family. And like Walt always believed in a big family, I believe in a big Disney family. It's we all understand each other. We're all, you know, we have this bond and connection, and understand the lighter things sometimes. It's hard to explain, but there's definitely something magical about the Disney family. And you know, with Thanksgiving now just down in the road for us, for Halloween, for the United States, it is definitely time about family. And it may be hard nowadays for us to spend time as family, but one way or another, reach out, tell someone that you love, tell someone that you miss them. Spend a little extra time with family and the members that maybe you haven't been able to see as much this year, or you just, you know, time has gone away from you and realize it's been a while. Start now. So thank you. Thank you again for spending some of your crazy time with me. And I really do appreciate it. Side note, as always ask, and I it does help out, and I do always appreciate it, the fact that, you know, so far, straight 5-star rating for this show. Go on to iTunes. Give us some more ratings. It helps other people find the show and see what's going on. Or tell other people. Word of mouth is always great, too. Tell other people while you're speaking around the Thanksgiving table or whatnot. Hey, I know you like Disney, too. Check out the Disney Marvel podcast. He's always got some interesting stuff going on there. While you're at it, also don't forget to subscribe to the show. This way, when you always know when a new episode is posted. But while you're at it, consider becoming a premium subscriber to help the show out. Help us afford different things and get things going. Equipment is not free, unfortunately. You can do this over at anchor.fm/DisneyMarvel/support. Or you can find our Patreon page. Links to both of those are in the show notes. Patreon, you'd actually get some nice little free stuff too. Whatever you're facing out there, whatever's going on. Again, it's the holiday time, and sometimes with the news and everything going on and things going backwards, it is hard. It is hard on everyone. I know it's hard on you. And you are not alone. You are not unloved. And maybe cold, and things may not seem bright, but there's a light inside of you that you should embrace. Be hard to find, but believe me, it's there. Embrace it, and it'll light up your world, and it will help you move forward. If everything else is going backwards, you just gotta keep moving forward. And this too shall pass. Be your own hero. Never give up, never give in. I believe in you as you should believe in yourself. Now, I'd like to end the show with a quote from Walt Disney himself. In my view, wholesome pleasure, sport, and recreation are as vital to this nation as productive work and should have a large share in the nation's budget. And that's Walt Disney. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone, and I'll see you next time.
Just a note to say,
dress warmly.
Eat well.
Stay safe and sound.
Keep smiling.
We're always there for you.
Signed,
your